As a contractor and engineer, you should utilize the best fitting for the condition. When you have unstable soils and high pressure applications, you should restrain your fittings. In today's video, we're going to show you the time savings of the TR Flex fitting system compared to the mechanical joint restraint system. Welcome to another edition of Iron Strong. My name is Scott Frank, and I'm the sales manager for McWane Ductile, Ohio. Here in front of me now are a couple of accessory kits for restraint joint fittings. We've got the nice small compact box of the TR Flex, which only has 6 accessory pieces. And over here in this big old box, we've got 10 pieces of mechanical joint accessories required to do the same thing. So here we are with the TR Flex system. It's as easy as this. Red stands for right hand. Drop it in. The black one is the left hand. Drop it in. Last step will be to put in your rubber spacer bar. The big difference goes into the labor of the joint, the man hours required to make the joint complete. So step number one will be putting the restraining gland on the pipe. Step two will be the rubber gasket going on after the gland. So now we're gonna hand tighten these with the ratchet as hard as I can, as much as I can with my strength. Again, it'll be a star pattern, again, like changing a flat tire in your car. And what I'm doing then is compressing the MJ gasket to make the watertight seal around the pipe. If we had a torque wrench, we would know the actual foot-pounds that I am putting on each nut and get within the engineer specifications. Just go to your AWWA manual and you can find 12-inch range for recommended foot-pounds. So I finally have the T-head bolts as tight as I can get them. I'm not going to use a socket for the next part. I'm going to go back around with the wrench and be sure I've got them all as tight as I can be. But don't forget, we're not done yet. After that, we still have to go break off the blue restraining wedges to make it a restrained joint. And again, those will be star pattern once again. And after that is complete, then the joint is finally assembled. But don't forget, had we went this route, drop and rotate, we'd be several minutes, maybe hours ahead, and then we could lay more pipe and install more fittings. There we go, folks. 8 blue locking wedges popped off at the proper torque pound to complete the last and final step of restraining this 12-inch mechanical joint 45.
So with the TR Flex, the pros will be less time, less tools, it weighs less, fewer parts, less chance of corrosion, and also less chance of leaks if it's pushed together correctly. On the con side, the access is not as good, it's not as readily available, and the makeup of the joint homing it is also a little more tedious than the MJ. On the MJ side, the pros, again, more readily available, easier to draw it together. However, it takes more time to put together, more tools are required, more parts, more chance for corrosion with the T-head system, and more chance of leaks if somebody doesn't tighten all the right bolts properly. Thanks for watching this episode of Iron Strong. Until next time, work hard, work smart, and work safe.